We're on to board reports. Board chair report, I would just like to read a response. We did have an open forum speaker a while ago that brought up an issue, and I'd like to speak to that this way. At the August 10th, 2017 board meeting, board members held a discussion concerning a site for a bus terminal facility. The bond approved by citizens allowed $3.5 million to be allocated toward the purchase of a bus terminal facility. The board approved in closed session, as allowed by state statute, the purchase price for a turnkey facility in the southern half of the district. I noted that this turnkey facility could be paid for by the bond allocated $3.5 million approved by citizens, $1.3 million in the district capital fund from the sale of the former Washington School, and $2 million from savings by not paying the next 10 years of lease payments for the current site. After I made this suggestion with my research supports, I was asked at the next open forum meeting to resign from the school board. In my research leading up to our board discussion, I phoned Eric Johnson, an administrator in my town of Oak Park Heights, and asked if there was any background information on the current bus site, since environmental questions had been raised about this site. He said he would look into the property material and get back to me. He later sent me reports related to the current bus site. I shared this material with my fellow board members. In reading through the material Mr. Johnson sent, I became alarmed at some of the information contained within the reports, which I clearly stated were from 1995. As a stage 4 cancer survivor myself, I noted especially some written material that said soil sample concentrations exceeded the acceptable target cancer risk level at numerous locations within the site boundaries. I was accused by the open forum speaker of fear-mongering by bringing this material to our discussion. In fact, I don't believe I would have done my due diligence if I knew about this material in the report and failed to call attention to it. The September 13, 2017 review of environmental reports and MPCA files done by Field Environmental Consulting chose to quote from the same report I quoted. They noted that data indicates that the estimated cancer risk exceeds targets at numerous locations for unrestricted and recreational land use. Field Environmental Consulting no doubt felt they were also doing their due diligence by highlighting this information. It was also said by the speaker that I demanded an immediate vote on the southern property on August 10th. In the 10 years I've been on the school board, no board members, including me, have ever demanded an immediate vote. The board members I have served with are thoughtful and courageous citizens and cannot be bullied into immediate votes if they aren't ready to vote. The truth is that board members took a vote to table a decision on the bus terminal location. The vote was 6-1, the issue was tabled, and the majority ruled as it should. I do want to thank the open forum speaker for reminding board members that we have a moral and ethical responsibility to function impartially to ensure the greatest good to the greatest number at all times. With over 60,000 district residents to whom we are accountable, our responsibility is always to ensure the greatest good to the greatest number, and I intend to continue to do just that until I decide to leave the school board. And that's my board chair report. Are there any board member reports?